Hello, audience. Welcome back. Archana, back with her brain tunes. And today I have with me one of the most illustrious lady leaders of the contemporary world. I'm glad and proud to announce and give to you Ms. Jyoti Agarwal from Mumbai, who is the founder of Ma to Mom, right? So welcome to my studios, ma'am. I would like you to introduce yourself.
Thank you so much, Archana. It's a pleasure to be here, and I'm really, really overwhelmed with all the love you have showered. And thank you very much, and I look forward to this conversation with you.
Right. So, ma'am is a personification of humility, I must say, viewers, because if you look at her accomplishments, you would not believe that such a humble, simple looking lady has so much of social service behind her back. So let me do, like it is my normal pattern, let me do a small introduction with a PPT for ma'am. So here we go. There we are. The drill, Brain Tunes with Archana. You can also listen to our conversation on Brain Rhymes Radio, which is broadcast in 14 countries across the world. And I will be putting up the links for you to download the application as well as listen. And you can meet us on YouTube, LinkedIn, any social media. And you can definitely connect with Ms. Jyoti Agarwal, who is the founder of Ma to Mom Global Community for Mothers. Now, the name itself is so very interesting. What is Ma to Mom all about?
Archana, Ma to Mom is a community for mothers. And why this name came from, because I, being from India, I don't think there is any word as powerful as the word Ma, because it's complete in itself. So I wanted to say that we are connecting the mothers across, from a ma who is from the last generation to a mom who could be from this generation, to a ma who's working at home or cooking at home or taking care of kids, to a mom who's going outside the world and facing the world and, you know, bringing some money to sustain her family. So it's saying that all in all, each and every mom and each and every generation of mom is included in this community.
Oh, that's beautiful, ma'am. And it's so much empowering to every woman who is actually essaying all of these roles which you have just mentioned. Going forward, Jyoti ma'am is holding a lot of titles. Founder of Ma to Mom, she priorly was a proprietor for Lucknowese. Now, how does this connect go, ma'am? What is Lucknow, or what is Lucknowese all about? And how is it that you ventured from Lucknowese into Ma to Mom?
So, yes, that was quite interesting, Archana. I belong to Lucknow, and Lucknowi hand embroidery is famous across the world. It's handcrafted, and I'm always towards, you know, handcrafted stuff, anything which is done with love, you can say, from the artisans in India. So that's how I got connected, and I thought, why not bring the Lucknowi to Mumbai and, you know, make it affordable and reachable more to people. So we started with manufacturing, wholesale and retail. So we had two outlets in Mumbai for across a good 6 years. And I was also doing, you know, wholesale to bigger brands, and we were doing retail outlets. So that was it for quite six, 7 years. But then motherhood came, and there were a lot of things going on, and Ma to Mom came in place, and I became a community leader there.
Oh, that's so very inspiring, ma'am. So when you talk about Lucknowese, is it the chicken curry work you're talking about?
Yes, the chicken curry, the Lucknowi chicken curry, yes.
Right, amazing. That's one of the, I guess, the most traditional methods of handcrafts, and it still holds a lot of value, very dear to many, many people. So coming to this picture here, Jyoti ma'am has also been associated with several top forums as a community leader, like she just mentioned. And she's also been with TED Talks. So ma'am, could you please throw light on this?
So we've been community partners with TED, you know, making it outreach to more audience and more people for TED Gateway and other. This picture was clicked when we were a part of the TED Soch, Nayi Soch, which was hosted by Shah Rukh Khan himself, and we had attended that event. It was mesmerizing. His presence was mesmerizing, and we really loved. And I still, you know, when I see this picture, I go back in time when I heard, you know, the founder of Goonj talking about his ideas and how he created Goonj. So it was a lovely day, and thank you, Archana, for getting this picture here. Brings in so many, you know, positive memories in me in this time when we are locked down due to this pandemic. Thank you so much.
Your voice encompasses all the nostalgia that you're going through right now, ma'am. Glad that I could fish up this picture and have our audience also know what we've been into. Right. So now this is something which is very, very interesting. So this was in 2019. So could you tell us what was Aram?
So Aram was an event which was created by, I'm very passionate about art because I belong to Lucknow. I love to write. I write poetry in Hindi. And so I also run a community called M2M Open Mic, in which we support the art, like the poets, the storytellers, those who love to write, those who love to recite, those who love to sing. We're trying to build a community for the talent also, apart from the community which you read about, Martumam. So this was an event in which they had a collaboration of art with some storytelling. So art was a form of a painting with storytelling, and it was an event which I attended, and some amazing artists had performed. So I was like proud to be a part of it, and I always love to support the art and the culture, you can say. This is something which is in me. It's not something which I do from the outer surface, but something which I really feel about. And I think our artists right now, also during the pandemic, we have been doing events in which somehow we can fetch in some money for the artist. So, yeah.
That's a real lovely initiative, ma'am, because we see all these hardworking artists struggling to make ends meet, and they do not even get 2 square meals a day. And taking up such initiatives is really heartening and encouraging. I think more and more people will be inspired by your story to look into these aspects and focus more on helping the artisans and the handicraft workers of our community.
Absolutely. So, we also do that. Yes. And right now, our, you know, the Prime Minister says this, and India needs it. You know, we have to be vocal for local. We have to make a, you know, self-sustainable India. And this is, I have been doing it from quite many years, Archana. Like from 6-7 years, I always talk about go local, you know, go and buy from local people. Don't order stuff from anywhere. Don't just go to mall and spend all your money. Also give, you know, opportunity to the small solopreneurs, the homepreneurs, and the artist. Not only the biggies, but the smallies also need some bit of your time and your investment in it.
Right. Encouragement, most importantly. Otherwise, the traditional arts keep dying if nobody values them. And we feel that even these talented artists are coming to the cities just to earn a living. We see them, they are laborers, blue-collar laborers, and all the talent is just going waste. So beautiful initiative. Lovely. Now, talking about this was something which actually caught my eye, ma'am. The causes that you've been for. So Pooja really supports mental. So could you please talk about this, ma'am? What was this all about?
So, you know, Archana, I always believe in people talk about only the women's side, that women are facing this, women are going through this. And me being a mommy community, they say, you know, I can be biased, but I am not. I always believe what is right, and what is wrong, it, irrespective of whatever your gender is. So I feel that your gender cannot decide that you're right or wrong. And Mentu was a moment which was run by Pooja Bedi, and we all supported the event because there were a lot of things happening around, you know, and a lot of men were being targeted for, you know, rape and stuff like that, in which they were not really involved. It was the female who were like using whatever the law was and putting them behind the bars and stuff like that. So there we were voicing out our opinion, saying that, you know, men too are facing it. It's not only the Me Too, but the men too also. So this was the huge event which happened in Azad Maidan, Mumbai, and I was very proud to be part of such an initiative. And it really, you know, turned the tables for men also. So it was a lovely initiative done by Pooja Bedi. And there was this lawyer which is very popular, Dr. Mrinali Deshmukh, I guess. So she was also a part of it, and I attended event and listening to the stories of the family. I mean, you'll be amazed to see the kind of issues they are facing without any fault of theirs. So it's a thing which people like us who are in community doing some social work, we should also see the other aspect also. That's why I came up with such an event.
Very nice, ma'am. So in fact, it definitely gives or process the mind that, oh, okay, feminism and feminist movement that explains mom and focus on women completely. But I completely agree to what you say, ma'am. It is not only women who are subjected to harassment, but also men. And sometimes women take undue advantage of the law, like the dowry harassment. Anything and everything. I have heard of instances wherein women threaten the in-laws, threaten the husband of complaining.
So the law has to be pure and it has to be irrespective of the gender. We cannot use our gender as a as something that, you know, we are blackmailing somebody or we are trying to do this. That's why this Me Too movement was very much necessary, because only Me Too was getting all the highlights and everybody was blamed after 6 years, 7 years, 4 years. Where was everybody 7 years back? You know, today you are raising the voice. So there were a lot of stories which were true, but there were a lot of stories which were not true, but, you know, they were coming in pictures. So this was also much needed that time, Archana, I think.
Right. But ma'am, I would like to know, what is your view about, you were talking about, why didn't they raise their voice when the incident happened, and why did they have to wait for 4, 5, 6, or 7 years? I guess it is a social stigma surrounding it, and the victim is the one who is blamed rather than the perpetrator. And I think that is the reason that many women didn't come out. I completely agree when you say that some men were unnecessarily embroiled in controversies which they were nowhere related to, and some unscrupulous women, I must say, tried to exploit the situation, whatever was there.
Should be very, very clear that because of few women, the whole whole womenhood is targeted. That should not happen, and that is the reason I took a lead in this. That there are so many women who are really facing, Archana, you know, in this pandemic also, I have taken a cause of domestic violence also, and day in, day out, I'm talking to women and trying to help them. They want to go back to their home. Husbands have just thrown them out overnight. Ki, just get out right now, you know, at 12 o'clock. And then she's calling me, Jyoti, where do I go? And then we just try that where she can go, which NGO can help and all that stuff. But it's not only happening with women. There are men also who are facing domestic violence. So we should not just be gender biased, saying that only women face domestic violence. There are a lot of men I know are also facing domestic violence. So it's not a gender thing. It's gender neutral is what I meant.
Right. But that's really... That's really chilling to hear too also, ma'am. Women trying to exploit things and turn tables in their favor. But then, like you said, yes, things will be out in open one or the other day, and they just can't keep pushing things to their advantage and feel that, okay, I will get away with anything and everything. Just like men are being pulled up if women are responsible for the miscreant. Yes,
correct. Correct. Absolutely correct.
Right. And tell us about what is Aspiring She. You've come up with all unique names, ma'am. So these are really exciting. So what is this Aspiring She?
Aspiring She is that's not something I have created. This is a brand. This dear friend Soumita Tiwari who's made this brand Aspiring She, and then we were the outreach partners again for her thing. If you can see, our logo is down like a community outreach partner down there. Martu Moms, she comes up, they run a digital magazine and they keep on doing lovely awards, you know, for women, and they keep on getting appreciation, motivation, come up with different topics of panel discussions. So there was this award which I was a part of, and we've been always associating to come up with causes and stuff like this. So this is what Aspiring She is all about. Yeah,
lovely, ma'am, lovely. And I see that you were the guest speaker and supporter for this particular event which was hosted. So let us see what this was all about. And awards that ma'am has been endowed with. So ma'am, could you please tell us what are these awards? It is again Aspiring She who has honored you. So tell us about this.
So this was Aspiring She 2020, which was hosted at Audi Mumbai, Andheri. And we were awarded as the Community Influencer of the Year. And the award was given by Amrita Fadnavis. And I was like very privileged. And when I was introduced to her and when she said, okay, Martu Mom is on Facebook and I know about it, I said, you can keep the trophy now. I got my award. She was like smiling all the way. I said, when you know about it, that means my work is going somewhere. And that's actually my trophy. So she was very impressed. And she's very, very motivating. I really loved meeting her. She's a beautiful singer and an amazing personality. And over the left side, that's a Seva Satkar Award, which I got in 2019, I think. And they had felicitated a lot of NGOs and other communities who are working for the society and making a difference. So I was privileged to be a part of it. While I would say, you know, I was the one of the newest one, and they were like commendable people who are doing some amazing stuff. I am a beginner and there is, you know, a lot to be done, Archana, honestly.
Undoubtedly, ma'am, with all that you have done, you still claim to be a beginner. That shows your humility, and that also shows a passion to grow to newer heights and help more and more women out there, and also men in cases where it is required. So, I guess this was a panel discussion. So,
There were some amazing panelists from Rekha Khan, editor of Navbharat Times, to Archana, who's a radio jockey, to Nibedita Basu. And we were talking about women empowerment, and what I was replying that, when do you think women empowerment would really come? And my reply was, women empowerment will really come the day the mother-in-law will take their daughter-in-law as their own daughters. That day it will be actual, real women empowerment. Talk about so much being happening, but in our own houses, you know, every day, Archana, trust me, women call me and they say they want to do, but they are not allowed to do. They are stopped to do. So the real empowerment will come when the bias will not be there between the daughter and the daughter-in-law. If that stops, there will be a lot of change. And the women should not be stopping the women. The women should not be jealous of the women. We should not be comparing with each other. Archana has her own beauty and Jyoti has her own. The day we come up with such things, then only it will be women empowerment. Because we talk so much, but at the end we are jealous. Ye ye kar rahi hai, ye wo kar rahi hai. We are always, you know, isne achha pehna hai. So before giving a compliment, we think how we can look beautiful. We have to be fearless as women. And that day the real empowerment will be shown, is what I believe.
A beautiful, ma'am. Lovely, lovely explanation that you have given. And aurat hi aurat ki shatru hoti hai. This is a very, very true fact. And
but agar hum saath dete hain, toh 1 or 1 2 nahi hote hain. Hum 1 or 1 11 ho jate hain. This is what I have been saying and doing. When I started saying this, Archana, people used to think ki main kya naya bol rahi hun. This is something which everybody knows. Ki, you know, support each other, motivate each other, appreciate. But today, my community is seeing this. If you go and see, there is a difference. People have started appreciating each other. And it's like a bank. You deposit and you withdraw. And people have started depositing and today they are withdrawing and they are just loving it that, you know, everybody appreciates me, Jyoti. Everybody appreciates me. By this appreciation, I have done this. By this appreciation, I have done this. So then I also feel so good that people are getting results of what I was talking, which, you know, whenever they come and tell me that, Jyoti, log to aisa nahi sochte, main aisa sochti hun. So I always tell them, if you think like this, why don't you perform? Why don't you be the change which you want to get? One day when you be the change, you will be able to bring the change. Every time you are telling me that this person is not doing this, if you are in agreement with this point, you only become the start point. And this is where, you know, Archana, I am really able to bring this difference. Every single person, when I tell 10 logon mein se 2 log meri baat nahi sunenge, lekin jo 8 log sunenge, wo 800 logon tak leke ja rahe. This is the power of networking, which Mom to Mom is doing. And today we are seeing an amazing difference which is happening.
Beautiful, man, lovely. So this is what I was looking at your Facebook profile, and I just related to the statement that you said, if you want to see change, you be the change. So lovely thought, ma'am. And please talk about all these lovely women that I see on the poster here, and what was this panel discussion about?
In the time when people say one community should not talk about the other community, we came up with a panel discussion in which all of them are community leaders. And we all came together and we spoke about what we are doing and why we are doing and how we are doing and how we are supporting each other during the pandemic. So this was also one of the beginning thing when people saw, oh, different community leaders on one community, they were like surprised how we are doing this. But this is how when a woman supports a woman, this power poster comes in.
Exactly. It's in fact, it's very heartening to see, you know, you have different areas there. And when these forces of nature come together, what not can be accomplished. So
Absolutely. Much more than even what we can think happens.
So that is what Jyoti Ma'am is all about, her motto, to bring the change, be the change. So ma'am, I would like to take forward our discussion in a couple of minutes, but this is a small title that I have given to you. I think this saying is made for you. Jyoti Ma'am, the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world. So somehow I love this statement and I feel it aptly fits you, ma'am. So this is dedicated.
So this means so much, Archana. This is very beautiful. I'm like really touched by all your efforts. The slides also, you've been like, you've got all the lovely pictures, and you know, during this pandemic, when everything is kind of stopped and, you know, we are just trying to get into whatever we can do because we are digital. So our work is not stopping and we are trying our bit to help and support the small businesses. This thing is surely a pat on the back which says, you know, we can do the world.
So just like you are contributing to the society in so many different ways, I am trying to make my own small mark by bringing people like you onto the fore and showing to the world that, hey, come on, look here, there are people who are doing things without covering for recognition, they're just going and doing. So it is like neki karo kue medal. That is what you are doing, ma'am. You're least bothered about any appreciations, laurels which come your way, but you're undoubtedly giving selfless hope, inspiration to many women around there. So ma'am, I would like to ask you, how do we actually handle, or how do we actually handle situations wherein women are abused, especially like you said, the mothers-in-law. And it's not that all mothers-in-law are evil or wicked. Now that has been the mentality. It is like mother-in-law looks like a monster. So I don't know why. So somehow I guess majorly it is the Idiot Box and the serials which have contributed to this sort of mentality wherein women are women.
I'm sure, yes.
No, exactly. Heavy jewelry and then plotting, planning, vamps all the way. They can go to any extent of even being the destructive force behind families. I've not seen this in real life. It doesn't happen. So do you think it is the influence of TV and all which is actually making women more and more averse against each other, especially in from the home front? Mother-in-law, they are actually damaging the delicate bond of mother-in-law and daughter-in-law is what I can say.
Arjuna, it's both ways, I would say. It's not only from the mother-in-law side, it has to be on the daughter-in-law side always. Again, I talk about equality. It's about mother-in-law also accepting her as a daughter and daughter-in-law also accepting her like a mother. So I've seen both aspects. So they, as I said, we are connecting generations. We have the grannies also with us and we have the mommies also. So there are cases in which the daughter-in-law doesn't accept her as a mom, even if she tries her best. And there are cases in which the daughter-in-law is not accepted even if she tries very hard. So there are both the scenarios. It just depends that what the state is. Yes, I would say a lot of times TV plays a vital role on getting the negative things in your life and the negative picture, the monster picture which you really stated. It's also about the culture in which India, in which we always thought that mother-in-law has more power and she has to dictate. So she always think, yes, I've become a mother-in-law, then I am the person, I'm the leader and I have to tell. But they don't understand that, you know, it's her family now and they have to accept her with all the love and affection, and that's where, you know, she becomes a part of the family. So that thing is really missing. Although there is a change, I would not say there is no change. There is a change. There was an era when I was married. I am a Marwari. I was asked to have a veil on my head when I was married, like 16 years back, but I was the one who voiced for it because I wanted to be the change. I had to do it only twice in a year, you know, when I go to my hometown, which was Bharatpur in Rajasthan. But I was thinking about all other Bahus who had to do the same thing. So I voiced out, I fought for it, and then I won it. And then today the change is there. And I am the most loved daughter-in-law in my family because they feel that I don't, you know, move things. I talk straight. I'm just straight. Whatever I feel, I express. I am the same to my family how I am to his family. For me, both of them are parents, and that's how now they've also started accepting me as their daughter. But still, there is a thin line, and there will be a thin line. That thin line has to be sorted, I would say. So yes, so we are working towards that thin line for the society as a whole. And I'm sure with the efforts of people like you, Archana, and people like me and the other who is connected in the society, we will be able to. Tomorrow, we are also going to become, mother-in-law. So let's be the change.
True, ma'am. I completely agree to that. If we want to produce a sound, both of us have to clap. Only I swinging my hand, you swinging your hand is not going to make any sound. Absolutely. Undoubtedly, from both perspectives, there should be a change. And people, women should understand that we have to stand for each other than stand against each other. And I think that will go a long way in cementing the bond. Ma'am, what do you think of... all these women who are highly educated, very talented, but are restricted from pursuing their dreams or career once they get married? They have to devote themselves to the kitchen and the household. So how do you think this mindset is going to change? And what can we do to encourage these women to, you know, how can they actually convince their family?
So I am, first of all, Archana, totally against this agenda which says that, you know, the women of the house cannot work, to be honest. Since I got married, my first condition was this, that when I get married, being from a Marwadi family, where my dad told me, "Hamare ghar ki ladkiyan kaam nahi karti," and I told him, "No, I don't want to work with you. I want to go work myself, make my money, and I can prove that maine kaam kiya, so I got money." My dad was, "Nahi, hamare ghar ki ladkiyan kaam karne nahi jaati. I will pay you more than what you're getting outside. Work with me only." But I refused because I wanted to prove myself, right? when I got married, the same thing came back again in picture, that काम करना है कि नहीं करना है. My first condition was this: I only want to get married in a family which gives me the permission to work. I don't want the permission whole life कि अभी कर सकते हो अभी नहीं कर सकते हो. तो I have always been working. So if you ask me, I would always say, why put a condition on a lady not to work? Let her pursue her dreams. Okay, fine, you want her to take care of the house, let her plan her way how she wants to take care of the family. Maybe she can have a help. But if she is an MBA and she can do a lot more, why she's only asked to roll chapatis? Let her, let it be a part of it. Let her take help and let her also roll chapatis. I'm not saying there is anything wrong in rolling chapatis, but why only roll chapatis after being an MBA or an engineer or whatever the girl is? I think she should be allowed to pursue her dreams. And we should do, you know, our bit in supporting, motivating, counseling the families, talking to the families, why it's happening. And if anybody comes to me, I have been getting lot of women, you know, talking about this, and we try our bit, talk to the lady first, and if needed, talk to the family. If needed, we, you know, advise them to reach out to the counselors for a family counseling. We try our bit. फिर भी आज भी बहुत सारी लोग women हैं, मेरे साथ भी काम करती हैं, जो mute पे mobile पे रख के काम करती हैं, and they don't tell the family they are working because the family is okay for them to watch Netflix for 6 hours, but they're not okay with them working or making money because वो कहते हैं हमारी family को जरूरत नहीं है पैसे की. Why you want to go and work? So they say it's not for the money everybody is working. There is something more than money which we get when we work, Archana. You would agree with me. It's not only money. It's something more which we get as an identity. That, you know, I want to be known not only like a wife or a mom or a daughter. I want my husband to be known by, you know, he's Jyoti's husband, or my daughter that she's Jyoti's daughter, you know. So this is also for what we aspire. Or after the kids are grown up, husband is busy in his own things, family is busy in their own stuff. Most of the women face depression. Why do they face? Because there is a void which is left in them. They were good painters, they were good artists, they were good in so many things, but the dreams are being, you know, closed down without any proper closure. So that's where that depression creeps in. So they need to, you know, have their identity, and I strongly believe that, you know, they should not be compelled not.
So what are your initiatives or ventures towards helping these type of women who actually have the skill and talent, and maybe they can do it in a small way but cannot go out and work?
So we do different type of things, from work from home opportunities we get in. We tie up with people who talk about what kind of work from opportunities. Tomorrow only I have a talk in which somebody from Singapore is going live with me, talking about aap content writer ban sakte ho, aap data entry kar sakte ho, aap ye kar sakte ho, whatever the different opportunities are. From there to women who are solopreneurs or homepreneurs, we come up with bazaars or exhibitions or event in which we try to promote them. Guys, this person is selling this, this person is selling this, go and buy from them. It's very easy to log on to Amazon and buy. But when you buy from a mom who's, you know, just trying to pursue her dreams, just by making achar, you are also supporting a dream. So I always buy my stuff from my mompreneurs before I buy from anywhere else. If I don't get from them, or there is something which I really need, then only there will be a delivery. My husband will always say, tum to dekhna hi nahi chahti ho Amazon ko, because I don't want it. I want it from my mompreneurs or my solopreneurs. So these are the two ways in which we help. The other thing is the talent part. As I said in the beginning, I run a community called M2M Open Mic, in which we also work on the talent part. There are women who don't want to earn money, but they write or they recite or they do poetries or they sing. So usme bhi we keep on working on their talents. You paint or you do anything. Do anything which makes you happy, to be an inspiration for your kids also. Because tomorrow, being a mother, the bachcha bhi aapko value nahi karega. If you are becoming just empty, giving it to them, and you are not enhancing your knowledge by doing something and learning something, you become an empty bottle after some days. So neither you will have love, nor you will have knowledge, nor you will have learning. What you are going to give your family or your child? So this is why I say every woman should be doing something apart from their family stuff, whatever they do. And we keep on motivating all the mommies for this.
Right. So you need to have time for yourself. You need to pursue your dreams, whatever. Not necessary that it has some financial gain, but at least to have that mental satisfaction of having accomplished whatever you are capable of. Lovely, ma'am. That's amazing. And audience, all of ma'am's social media handles will be mentioned on our channel here, and you can just go over, and in case you want to get in touch with ma'am, you can find her on the social handles that I have here. Right, so ma'am is available on all of these handles. She's on Facebook, she's on LinkedIn, she's on Insta. All of these handles will be available just a click away below our channel here. So you can just go and subscribe, be a part of her community, and help yourselves, also help other women who are in need of exposure, because this is a safe community where women interact and you needn't worry, because there's another of these preconceived notion. I can't say it's a preconceived notion. It is also a fact that you may be duped. Right. And so social media is something which we have to be very careful about. So women are also afraid of this, ma'am, as to what if it goes into the wrong hands. And that is the reason that many women hesitate from interacting on the social media. But if you're talking about displaying of talent,
we come up with things in which people can talk one-on-one on Zoom calls or stuff like that. If they have any issues, they can reach to our team, and whatever issues they are going through, there are people who write mails to us, Archana, and we post their questions as anonymous posts asking about any unforeseen situations they are going through, and they don't want to show their names. So we keep on posting stuff. So we are always there to support of any of the causes any women is going through. Our main agenda is, after you become a mother, don't think motherhood is your weakness. Think motherhood as your strength, and don't kill the women inside you. Motherhood brings more power to you. It doesn't reduce your power.
That is a beautiful, beautiful note, ma'am. And on this note, I would be taking leave of you. And Jyoti, ma'am, a few inspiring words for our women viewers here.
So I always, as I say, you are the power. Just see it in you. Every day, see yourself in mirror and tell yourself you're powerful. And that comes to you. I believe in manifestation, and you also try believing in that.
That was beautiful, ma'am. It was amazing having you on the show, and I hope all the women out there who are looking out for support in the form of women's groups, and where they can nurture their talents and also pursue their dreams, are most welcome to join Jyoti ma'am on Ma to Mom on different platforms, and then realize their dreams is what I can say. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Archana. Thank you for Brain Tunes. And it was amazing to, have this chit chat with you, Archana. Take care of yourself. Much love your way.
Thank you, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.